Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Super Mario Galaxy. Sorry about that, Toad. We got a letter from Peach, which is probably going to be into the 5 1-ups, right? Yep, 5 1-up mushrooms. I'll go ahead and take those. So, last time we did some more stars in the engine room, including one of my favorites being the Mario Meets Mario star. Well, maybe not one of my favorite stars, but one of my favorite, like, concepts, like using the sprite of Mario. And in this episode, I think we're going to start off by having an awkward wall jump right there. We're going to go ahead and feed this hungry Luma. Because, we unlocked him last time. He needs 1,000 star bits. We have more than enough. And, in fact, we may have enough to feed the rest of the hungry Lumas. I think there might only be one more hungry Luma. And I think we already have enough star bits to feed him. So, somehow, I think I might have been, collecting the right amount throughout the game. Anyways, let's fly to the Sand Spiral Galaxy that just opened up. And let's see. Choosing a favorite snack. All right, let's go. Now, I don't really know why this is called Sand Spiral. I guess there's sand and it's kind of in like a spirally sort of platform, I guess. Or planet, or platform. But, yeah. So, choosing a favorite snack is an interesting star. Let's get rid of friggin' Magikoop. Right off the bat. We really don't want him around here. Oh, I can't get rid of him now, can I? Nope, he's gonna be a pain this whole time. So, as you can see, you can either choose the bee mushroom or the boo mushroom. I'm gonna go ahead and choose the bee mushroom to start off with here, because of course with the bee mushroom you can go through, oh god, I'm dead. I wasn't even paying attention just then. You can go through the light. With the boo, you can't go through the light. Now of course the boo doesn't have a limited flight time. You can fly indefinitely with the boo, and I don't know why I just did that. Also, I'm curious while I'm here. Nope. I thought maybe we could long jump to that, but no. Alright, not happening. So yeah, I would normally go with the boo for pretty much the whole time, but I want to try and show off both. And also, yes, finally we killed the Magikoopa. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and start off with B, because I believe you can switch to boo a little bit later into the thing. I was debating whether to do 2 run-throughs of this level, but I figured what's the point, basically. So of course, it's set up to compensate for both. In fact, you know what? No, let's not do that yet. Let's stay as B for now. It's set up so that if you're the B, you've got, of course, these coins that you can go after so that you can grab some more flight power. There we go. All right. Get rid of you. Let's grab the boo shroom now so we can use that for the end here. I believe if we get hit by the water here as a boo, it doesn't do anything. I could be wrong, but I don't want to find out. And of course, we just got to avoid the light right here. And the boos will, of course, the other boos will, of course, be in love with us, so that's also a problem. Hello, Toad.
It's bright because of the moon light!
Thank you. That is the moon, though, isn't it? Oh, God. I don't know. Anyways, so this section, we are, we're invincible. And we've got this friggin' moving platform right here. In fact, is this moving inward? That is not moving inward. Oh, God, I'm gonna screw this up. Hold on. Can we just make this? Yes, we can. Okay. Shortcut. Basically, the rainbow star is there to kind of increase your speed when running around that spinning platform. I guess that's probably why it's called Sand Spiral, maybe. I don't know. But you can just do a long jump like I just did there and basically get to the end no problem. So, yeah. There we go. 75 stars. You got a decent amount of star bits still, which is very, very nice. Okay, still looks like it's still just the engine room that has stuff. I don't think we got any more comet stars to do anywhere, other than, of course, like, the engine room, so, it's probably just gonna be engine room for a little bit here. For a little, probably an episode or two more, so, yeah. Anyways, oh god, there we go. So we're just gonna make our way in here again. Go ahead and, let's see, we have one in Gold Leaf, one in Sea Slide, one in Toy Time. So I guess we'll do one of each here. Let's start off with Sea Slide. Actually, let's go in alphabetical order. Let's start off with Gold Leaf. Because I think the Gold Leaf one has kind of been sitting there for a little while. We did like the second star, then the secret star, and the third one's just been kind of sat there. So when it rains, it pours.
Hey,
Alright, so we got this whole wooden structure here. Above the galaxy, which I don't think has been there yet. And we also have all of these storm clouds. Now, the main thing about the storm clouds is if you are B Mario, which we're gonna be in a, second right here. That's not what I meant to do. Hold on. Let me do this. There we go. If we're B Mario, we can stand on top of these clouds, as expected, but if we were to touch the rainwater, just like with regular water, you would lose the B power-up, which I guess this is technically regular water, it's just coming out of a cloud, so... Yeah, also I want to go up here. I am curious if there's anything different up here to normal. Nope, looks like it's just the same old boring star bits, okay. Bye, star bits. I think we probably don't even have to do any more star bit grinding in this LP. I think we have as many star bits as we need. I mean, there is a bonus for getting 9999 star bits, but I can show that off in, like, the bonus episode, so... Yep. Anyways. Let's just head up here. And of course, if I was going for 999 star bits, I would probably just grind in Sling Pod Galaxy, so... What are you? I don't know what... Oh, God. Well, I guess we're going down! I didn't mean to jump down there, but I'm curious what this does now. A one-up. Is that seriously just for a one-up? Go away. Go away. Okay, wow. 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 Alright, let's just friggin' get that again. And then immediately lose it because physics. I don't know, would a bee getting affected by water count as physics? Why is this happening to me? Do we have to get up here first? Is that what you're telling me? Die. I want your star bits. Okay, get the bee. There we go. I think we're okay now, maybe. Oh, you can't home in with the friggin' bee suit. I forgot about that. Alright, let's try this again, Mario. Let's maybe not fall off this time. I keep forgetting you can't long jump. I really wish the bee suit had a long jump. It's so... So... Well, I guess it would make it maybe overpowered, but... It is so missed. I miss it right now. I want a long jump. For example, oh god, let's get the L of star bits. In Super Mario Sunshine, there's no long jump, right? But there's enough movement options in Super Mario Sunshine to where it doesn't really need the long jump, at least in my personal opinion. In this game, there is the long jump, but it gets taken away from you when you're a bee, and I almost missed that jump again, because you can't just make it with a single jump, you gotta actually fly. Okay, got it, thanks game. But, when it's taken away from you, it makes you really miss it again, just because you had it in this game, so... I don't know, that was a friggin' random topic of conversation, but okay. So they got another bee shroom right there, because now on this platform we have some rain clouds, some thunderstorm clouds, clouds that are raining, that's the thing. Alright, let's just get up here. That one disappeared when it got over to the right there, so we can actually fly around here. As opposed to going around to the left, this is going to give us a bunch of star bits. We can go ahead and ground pound up. And there we go. I think that's the end of the area with the storm clouds. I don't think there's any more storm clouds in this level. Although, now I've said that. Come on, Mario. There you go. There's probably going to be more storm clouds. Yep, okay, I forgot about this one. We're fighting this dude again, the Undergrunt Gunner. I think that's his name anyway, except this time he's shooting water, so of course we can't be for very long. And he's got a storm cloud kind of on his side right here. So I've actually beaten this this boss fight in like 5 seconds. Well, not 5 seconds, but you know, quickly, just by flying over to the guy. And I don't know why I didn't do that now, but I did kind of want to show off these platforms that you can rise up by hitting that switch, which I think were a thing in the original fight with this guy in this galaxy as well. But something you can do is just this. You got the bee, just fly up and friggin' ground pound. Yeah, he's gonna get really mad, and we're gonna do it one more time. Never mind. Okay, lost the bee suit, and there isn't another one to get here. So, the bee suit is a really big. It gives you a pretty decent advantage. Also, I'm getting destroyed right now. Gives you a pretty decent advantage in this mission. Oh, you know, in this this boss fight at the end here, but it's not required. Oh God. Okay, we gotta hide here. He shoots a bunch at a time now, apparently. Okay, let's friggin'... No! Mario! Stop it. Okay. You know what? We don't even need those platforms over there, I don't think. We can just get up here, turn around, backflip. Yes! There we go. Nice. So you can even beat it without having to use those platforms, even if you don't have the bee suit, which is pretty nice. So, yeah. That's the kind of platforming I really like in this game, where you can just sort of do stuff that maybe wasn't intended, or wasn't really, I guess, the intended way of doing it, but it's in the game in case if you know, like, advanced platforming strategies, I guess. I don't even know. I just like doing that kind of thing in these games. It's the same with Sunshine. Oh, hello. Fast Four Comet's back. Oh, God. I don't want to do it yet. Also, S comes before T, so I'm gonna go to C slide. But, yeah, it's... I don't know what I'm trying to say. Like, in Sunshine, you can do amazing platforming things in that game. Anyway, the Silver Stars of C slide. Oh, boy. Let that intro to the song play again, because oh boy. Alright, so the Silver Stars of Sea Slide. There's only ever 5 Silver Stars when there's a Silver Star mission. Sea Slide's a pretty big place. So, this mission right here can... It's not necessarily tough. It can just be pretty time consuming, and I actually forgot that that's what this mission was. So this may end up being the last mission of the episode. It may be. I don't actually know at this point. Obviously, so it really just depends how long it takes. Also, draw distance on those freaking on those starbits right there was pretty lengthy. All right, go ahead and fly over here. Also, there's a hungry Luma over there now, so we could technically just do the hungry Luma star now, but we're not gonna do that because, of course, that's how I've been doing stuff here. We've just been doing the regular star first, followed by the secret star. Alright, Toad, you were building this a while ago. Cannons, they're a blast. He finally finished his cannon, so we are actually going to go in here. We're going to go ahead and fire our way over to the star shroom, and then use the pole stars, which are, for some reason, out here, to grab the next silver star. And then let's do this. Grab the one-up, just because it's there and we can. And there we go. So that's the location of the second silver star. We're not even that far around the galaxy yet. Actually, no, we're probably like a third. Not a third, just a little less than a quarter. I don't even know. I don't know what I'm trying to say anymore. Okay. Okay, let's just get over here. I'm actually gonna go in the water here, because we want to get this shell. Actually, this might not be a requirement, but I think it's something you can do. You can't destroy, or you can't defeat the Koopa Troopa when you are in a bee suit, so you can't actually get a shell when you're in a bee suit. However, oh, it's just star bits? Really? I could have sworn that that was a thingy. What's the buzz about the bee butcher? Blah, 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 blah. Maybe if you tried it, Toad, you'd look adorable. I don't know. You know, there's actually not a silver star in here. It's just star bits. And is there something up here? Or am I thinking of a later mission? I think I might be thinking of a later mission. I did just see a star bit, though, that I want. Because I collected all the rest of them. So I'm going to grab you. Any more? Silver one right there. All right, and in fact, you may have just seen the next silver star. It's going to be right over here. Oh, here. Okay, let's just fly our way up to the top of this tree, land, jump again. There we go. Now, I'm actually doing crouch jumps, even though I don't know if it actually makes a difference. All right, so there's this conveniently placed sling star right here. If you want to go see the captain, just use this sling star. I'm going to go ahead and do that. Because, when I said the entirety of the level, I wasn't being entirely truthful. So once you get those three, you can actually head back over here using the sling star, which is actually what you want to do. And we can land, there we go. Now you actually want to head over this way, onto this big old tree, which maybe you thought that we couldn't actually get on earlier in the missions of this level, I guess. But nope, you can actually get on this tree. And with any luck, there we go, we can fly up here. And once we're up here, I believe our silver star is awaiting us. Right on top of the tallest point of the tree, which I think either this or the center platform is the highest point in the level. This is the highest point in the level, I think. Oh, that might be, I don't know. Alright, so dropping down. Once we get down here, we got another sling star to go back to Captain Toad, or the start of the level. Or we can do this. which makes water defy physics. We can go ahead and jump in there. And that's going to bring us all the way over here. I don't think we've seen that yet, but if we have, I just repeated mundane information. Anyway, so actually we've got some musical notes in this, I think. Yes, we do. I'm going to be quiet. Yay, a one-up that I really don't need because the game just resets the lives whenever you restart the game anyway. Also, money bag or whatever the heck your name is. I don't know, it was said in a previous episode. Get back here. Get back here. Get back here. Ugh, got him. Die, give me your star bits. Thank you. Whenever you see those guys, grab them because they give you a decent amount of star bits. Also, hi. Let me do this real quick. There we go. I just wanted the satisfaction of killing that guy. Don't quote me on that. Okay. Oh my god, look at him. Not the penguin, the crab. He's got a friggin' death stare right there. Oh my god. Anyways, final silver star is up there. What are you gonna say, Penguru? There's all kinds of hubbub and sea slide. What's going on? You, sir, had a freaking demon look a second ago. I'm just gonna freaking kill you. Alright, and of course, collecting all 5 silver stars will make this appear. Actually, no. I think it's just collecting that silver star makes that appear, because you could, of course, get that one. You could get that one first if you wanted to, but anyways. Heading back here, we can grab the star. I don't know why I went quiet there. I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna be quiet for this, but I never play the audio loud in that cutscene, so anyways. We are sitting at about 17 minutes, I think, so I think we've got time to do one more. It's, of course, gonna be in toy time. And it's more than likely gonna be the comet star? Oh, it's gone. The comet is gone. Yay. All right, so we just get to do the regular mission in toy time, which is what I wanted to do. Because I didn't want to friggin' deal with the fast foe comet right now. All right, what do we got? Bouncing down cake lane. Okay, we're gonna be bouncing. Okay, maybe I would have preferred the comet. Not gonna lie. So I wanna grab these star bits real quick, so I'm just gonna... There we go. Yeah, bouncing down cake lane. Also, this is adorable. Star bits on the spoons like that. And right here in the center of these things, I don't even know what they're supposed to be. Bouncing, of course, means spring shroom. Why the heck would it not? Okay, oh, long jump. Oh, no. That is a good omen if I've ever seen it. I just wanted to see what you said. Yeah. Did you notice that thingamajig? You know, the springamajig. Aren't you adorable? Okay, do you say anything else now I'm in the spring? Yeah, yeah. Speak. Like that. Okay. So, bouncing down cake lane, of course, is going to be... a spring shroom level. I just missed all of those. And then I grabbed them all on the way back down. Okay. Bounce our way up between these two cakes, or whatever the heck these things are. Sandwiches? Why would it be sandwiches when this is bouncing down cake lane? Self. Okay. Also, is there like kiwi in that cake? That's a little odd, but okay. To each their own taste. Oh, God. I ground pounded a little bit too early right there. On the bright side, though, we're grabbing a whole bunch of star bits from this because we keep dying and getting more, so I am not complaining. Well, I mean, I am complaining because I'd like to do the level without dying, but star bits are a nice... star bits make up for it, I guess. All right. Go ahead and bounce over you. This bit is honestly the hardest bit of the whole level, I think, just because the spring shroom can be so awkward to control, and then you're dealing with a moving platform. Also, hello, grabbed you. Nice. You're dealing with a moving platform, and also these things which can also push you, so a little bit annoying. Also, I'm not even gonna go for that one-up right now. I do not trust my luck. Okay, this right here might be the bit that I was thinking of in one of the earlier missions where I was like, oh, you can just skip this entire section. I think if you go to the end of this fork... Nope. Hold on. Mario. Mario, why aren't you bouncing? There we go. Okay, ground pound to bounce. Yep, you can just skip that entire thing. Just bounce over that and you don't have to go the long way around. Alright, now we're on some ice creams. Which are of course not, cakes. But they've started playing the Icy World music. I think it plays in Freeze Flame. Basically any ice area, really, this seems to play. And it's so relaxing and creepy at the same time, so I'm okay with this. And it's ice, of course, because ice cream and lollipops and stuff like that. I was gonna say sunshine and rainbows, but that really doesn't insinuate ice, so let's not say that. Okay, grab you. Is there anything in this one? I don't think there is. Nope, but I just wanted the satisfaction of breaking that open. Alright, let's... Oh, no, Mario! I've never had that happen to me before! Alright, let's, just not skate across here, I guess. Let's just friggin' jump slowly. Alright, first person real quick so I can grab these star bits without having to do it later. And all of these ones! Oh my god. I've never done that before, but that's a whole bunch of star bits for us. Okay. Nope. 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 Also, I love that these are like little swirly lollipops. And you can- oh no. And you can even stand on like the stick and everything like that. I just think this is a really neat level. I know I don't like the bit with the spring shroom, but I like this bit. Alright. Heading back here. Oh god. Oh god. Break out, Mario. What are you doing? There we go. Oh, grab the life shroom. There we go. Make our way back up here. We have a cannon. Now we could have fired in here and grabbed the star bit. Oh, actually, we could have gotten on the pole stars to grab the star bits, but I grabbed them earlier, so everything's okay. And now, there's a lot of people eating this cake, and for some reason it just defaulted back to the regular Toy Time music, which was a little awkward, but okay. So heading around here, this person is eating a warp pipe for some reason. Let's go ahead and collect this, and musical notes, okay. I just feel like that ends way too quickly. It sounds a little odd. But you get a one-up from doing that. I honestly thought those spiky plants might have, like, exploded into star bits when I did that. But no, they didn't, and I don't want to do that because I don't want to die. Let's just make our way back over to the stairway of forks or spoons or whatever this is supposed to be. This person has a lot of people to their birthday party who all want cake at the same time. Jeez, dude, wait your turn or just get a party bag. Alright, so of course, it's a birthday cake. We gotta blow out all the candles. And you may hear there's like a little jingle that plays whenever you do it. Getting higher and higher every time. We just got one more candle. There we go. And just before we do that, got a whole bunch of star bits going around the edge right here. Nice and decorated cake. Then up here, we can spin the little jelly tot things to make even more star bits. Alright, oh, and even more. Like little donut moon things. I don't even know what they're supposed to be. But here we are. The second time fighting Undergrunt Gunner in this episode. Alright. This one is a little different, though. He's actually shooting these electrical balls, which is a little different to what he normally does. Or maybe he does this in other ones and I don't recall. Anyways, the main gimmick of this fight, of course, it's bouncing down Cake Lane. You gotta use the spring shroom, and spinning here doesn't make these come out of the ground for some reason, which really puts me off, because that should work. Alright. So of course it's the spring shroom, that's the only way we can reach him right now. I'm gonna go ahead and ground pound, and it's basically just gonna be the same boss fight, other than the fact that we gotta use the spring shroom. But honestly, as you can see, I'm pretty close to him right now, and if I could just... No! Oh, I was gonna say if I could pull this off without ground pounding into that, but then I ground pounded into that. Alright, I think it might be possible to reach him without the spring shroom. I'm gonna give it a shot real quick. Can I stand on you? Nope. Oh god. Okay, I should probably grab that life shroom. Can I do that from here? Yeah, okay, that restored the 2 health rate. Actually, I probably just could have killed the Mega Koopas to do that, but oh well. Let's get you from this side so we're already going in the right direction, because that could be a little awkward to realign. Alright, you do your thing. Bounce, and ground pound! And that is that. That is the next Undergrunt Gunner taken out. And as you can see, there's actually a 1-up up there. I think we can only reach that if we bounce off of Undergrunt Gunner's head. Oh. Oh, I'm curious now. Please don't collect the star yet, Mario. I want to grab that. If it's possible to grab that 1-up, I would like to grab that 1-up. Nope. I guess we got to bounce off of Undergrunt Gunner's head. Anyways, star. It took a little bit of time, but we got the star. So, yeah. With that, I think that is going to go ahead and do it for this episode of Super Mario Galaxy. A little bit of a longer episode this time. It's kind of why I'm starting the outro a little earlier than I normally would. So we got 78 stars total, though, which I think is pretty good progress for, what, 18 episodes, 19 episodes? So, yeah. Let's just take a quick look right here. We got a Cosmic Comet and Gold Leaf. We still got to do the Secret Star in Sea Slide, and there's the Fast 4 Comet and Toy Time. So we got a little bit of stuff left to do in the engine room. If we get those three done next episode, we'll probably also get to do the enemy base, depending on how things go. But, yeah. That is going to go ahead and do it for this episode of Super Mario Galaxy. So, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like and let me know- I should have stopped it. And let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys... then. Oh.